Hello, Tom Wilkinson.
Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm well.
Lounging, I see.
Yeah, in the lodge.
So the first thing I wanted to ask you, your character in the film is sort of the only character that already has a connection with India, that has already been there in the past. Is that, had you ever been to India? Had you ever, no? Did you have any connection or anything?
No.
Did you do any prep for it then? Did you do any research or did you do any preparation on the character for?
Well, I didn't. I mean, I just thought, here is an interesting situation. A man is sort of, you know, the story of the of my that character's story is that he wants to reclaim his life. He feels that in a certain sense he's lived a lie. Mm-hmm. All his life he's lived very successfully and very comfortably. But he wants to sort of reclaim his life, reclaim sort of who he is, reclaim, as in fact, his sexual identity, which he feels important. And that's probably one of the themes of that, of this movie, is that when people, when people reach a certain age, they might have a subconscious desire to sort of renew themselves in a way, prepare themselves. I don't know how you describe it, but that's something I sort of recognize without being able to put words to.
That's really interesting, because I feel that a lot of the times when I've spoken to people about this movie, what people focus on is the exoticism, and it is the fact that it speaks to a film demographic that isn't always necessarily touched upon. But you're the first person that I spoke to that sort of, I guess, spoken about it from the perspective of the characters, probably because you're the first person, the first actor from the film that I've spoken to.
Do it.
You know, sort of about what their impetus is, if they all share a common reason to go to the hotel. Do you know what I mean? Does that make sense?
Well, they do have different reasons, and, you know, it's perhaps possibly subconsciously have that one, and somehow this glorious enigma that is India can somehow provide some solution to something that the boring England can't do.
Well, do you think that that is an idea that sort of lives within England because of the relationship between England and India? And is that something that you think maybe subconsciously people think about more than they would think?
I don't know. It's a really, really, really complicated question. But somehow abroad always looks more exotic than where you are, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, the grass is always greener.
There is something like that, but it's a more complicated question you ask, and I don't really have the answer to
Okay.
it.
Okay. I just met John Madden for the first time. Interesting fellow. This isn't the first time you've worked with him. What is it like working with him as a director? What is sort of his... what attracts you to a project that is helmed by him?
Well, he gets good scripts, and that's initially what actors go for. At least, yeah, they do. They read a script and think, "I want to do this," and that's it, regardless of who's directing it. Sometimes you can think, "Oh, I don't know," you know, some mitigating the features that you think, "Well, no, I'm not going to do it." But usually, if the script is good, you'll do it. So, you know, John's handed me over the years a few good scripts, and I've been happy to do them.
Did you have an immediate response to the script for Best Exotic Marigold Hotel? Was it something that immediately drew you in, or was it something that you took time?
No, I liked the idea, and then it went away and changed a lot, because it was, I think there were two or three different producers. I can't really remember how it worked, but, I first knew about it quite some time ago, and then it got rewritten and stuff like that. So, but by the time I was given the final version, I was very happy.
How long were you in India for? Approximately
9 weeks.
What was the most interesting part about filming there? Had you ever? You said you hadn't been there before, but so I guess you hadn't filmed there before, obviously. What was the most interesting part about being there?
Everything. You have no idea what culture shock means unless you've been there. Or some sort of equivalent. I mean, I've never been to the sort of, to Africa much, or you know, to the Far East, perhaps places in China, but there's sort of contrast between the rich and the poor. you know, some woman washing her child in the puddle in a road and then washing her clothes in there, and you just think, how could you live, how do you live like this? And then wealth that you wouldn't dream of. I mean, it's just all living side by side in this crazy, chaotic pandemonium that is, you know, that is India. It's not all bad. There is a positive energy coming from the place, which, you know, is attractive, unlike nothing you've ever encountered. But it's kind of scary.
Yeah, I've never been, but from what I've learned from the movies and what I've read, it always seems like such a dichotomy, like what you were just explaining. Like, it seems like it's so beautiful and it's so colorful and there are so many interesting people, which I feel like this film translates really well. But then you have, for example, where, well, not to give anything away, but where you have these like kind of big call centers and where one of the characters goes to work, and it does seem like this sort of like bizarre modern sort of poverty next to all this sort of like traditional, what you would think when you think of the word India. I don't know, it just seems like a very interesting place.
Well, it's a land of contrasts and mystery. You should go. You should go, actually.
It is on my list of things to do after seeing this film. I'm not going to lie.
You should go.
One of the funny things that we were going through in the office when we first saw the movie was trying to sort of connect the dots between who had worked with who before, since the cast is such a great ensemble. Was there a sort of, what's the word I'm looking for, camaraderie, I guess, between the cast? Or was it like, you know... Was there sort of like kindred?
Every night, more or less.
Obviously. Oh, did you?
Okay. No, I'd worked with Judy a few times. Ronnie, certainly. Bill, certainly. Penelope, not at all. But you sort of knew, you know, you got lots of friends in common, so yeah, there was a camaraderie. You know, it was like being in a repertory company in England.
Yeah.
You know, out in the...
Only on vacation.
Out in the provinces.
That's really interesting. In England, the film is doing very well. Mm. It's done well at the box office. Why do you think this film particularly has resonated so well with the audience there? Other than just being a good film.
Other than being it's a beautiful masterpiece. I don't know. It's people have seen, recognized something in it. It isn't the run-of-the-mill, it's not, you know, X-Men 3, it's not, you know, it doesn't have any of that sort of stuff. It's got, I don't really know, I can't really explain, it's a bit of a mystery, because when I first saw it, I just thought, well, maybe. But people have seen it, and they've liked it, and they've talked to their friend, they've told people about it, and it's worked that way. So there is a sort of resonance about the movie that, you know, that strikes people. But I can't really explain it.
Understandable. Well, that's all the questions I have. Thank you very much.